Jim.
Jim Hagen, 150 Maple Drive, Cape York. And just to follow up on those statements, because it hasn't been brought up here with so many other issues going on, but sort of in conjunction with that decision that Jim was talking about early in the month was a similarly important decision, which was the Caper versus Sims decision, which has, I think, a direct bearing on critical areas ordinance-related issues that have gone on here for 2 years. And there are, you know, we've often talked about the differences between us and King County, but there are some striking similarities about what went on, their process there, and what went on here. One being tremendous public participation and objection to the provisions of what was viewed by many rural landowners as onerous infringements. And those objections were ignored and were taken to court. And I think we're finding a trend with the Skagit case a year ago and the Caper case and now with this SMP case, that the court is acknowledging that environmental regulations have to follow certain constitutional provisions. And some of those is you have to show that cause and effect relationship between the regulation and the specific harm that it's designed to prevent. And these across-the-board, generic, fixed-width buffers that apply across the landscape do not meet those constitutional tests of nexus and rough proportionality. And I think that's going to become, I urge the commissioners to kind of look at this, because I think it's going to be required. You're going to have, that's one of the things that we asked this whole time, show us where the harm is occurring and why the current regulation is not working and how this increased regulation is going to prevent that harm. How exactly are you going to protect? And these generalized moderate risk type approaches, the courts are ruling are no longer sufficient.